Are you looking for an easier server and systems monitoring solution? Tired of trying out products that come with six-figure consulting fees to get them to be useful? Then take a look at what Uptime Software is offering. Hello, I'm David Strom, and welcome to another of my screencast reviews. We're looking at its web console that shows a global dashboard and the status of our entire infrastructure on a single screen. Like other products in its space, Uptime consists of a monitoring station that collects information from a series of agents installed on each server. If we click on the Applications tab, we can see more details about the various applications on our network. You can see we're having some issues with our Microsoft Dynamics installation, as each box indicates a particular service being monitored, and we can expand this view to drill down further to get more specifics. Clicking at the top of the screen on Syslist will enumerate all of the servers discovered by Uptime in a separate window. This is a quick way to navigate around, as each server is hyperlinked. You can also see here the wide range of things that Uptime can monitor. To further illustrate Uptime's breadth, let's add a new network device. When we examine the drop-down choices that are available here, we have quite a selection to choose from. Uptime can automatically monitor a variety of Windows, Oracle, MySQL, WebSphere, and VMware events without needing any separate agents to be installed. If we go to the Services tab, we can show you how easy it is to create a new service monitor. The software prods you by having a series of annotated clickable image maps to show you the sequence of steps and the choices involved. Uptime can also automatically discover devices and add them to its monitoring. It will try to ping a range of IP addresses and then see if they can be reached via Windows monitoring or a variety of SNMP and NetFlow interfaces. Uptime has a very flexible reporting module that can be used to keep track of your infrastructure. If we go back to the Global Scan and click on Resources Scan tab, we can bring up a series of gauges that display the most recent 15 minutes across the top. The second row shows min and max values for the past day, and the graphs below have more specific information. If we click on the Reports tab, we can set up recurring reports that can be scheduled and saved or emailed to the boss, with a wide variety of choices that are displayed in the left-hand menu. Here we're looking at this report of various resources used. One of the most useful reports is the Service Monitor Usage report, and we can examine historical information for two of our Active Directory servers here. You can see we've had problems with our IIS web server. This gets into one of the more interesting things that I liked about the product. Uptime has the ability to automate some common self-healing tasks. We can set up this action profile in the Services tab that can detect when IIS is down and can automatically restart it without any need for operator intervention, a very powerful feature. I also like the ability to restrict the software to particular segments of your network, and you can do this in different ways by adding a view in the infrastructure menu so that departmental admins can't see everything. Uptime monitors both physical and virtualized servers and applications, along with a variety of network events across your entire infrastructure. It's easy to install and cost-effective to deploy. A free 30-day trial of Uptime is available at their website. You can start monitoring and reporting in about 15 minutes. Thanks for watching webinformant.tv. This is David Strom, and here you can find links to my email newsletter, other screencast reviews, and speaking engagements.